everybody, this is Sherriet, djsundry@blogspot.com, and welcome to my little stop on the Three Girl Jam blog hop. We are so excited to be showing you the new products that are available and to be hopping along with fun Christmas inspiration. Now, a few days ago, I posted a video where I made a flower for you. And as I promised, that flower is kind of the centerpiece of my project today. But first I want to get started and show you what I have to share with you. I'm going to set this Three Girl Jam goodness aside and pull out some other stuff. I use my Zig Writer. This is in pure red. I have some tabs that I made on my Cricut, and these are tabs that I actually made probably about a year ago or close to a year ago. And they were used, I made them using the From My Kitchen Cricut cartridge. And so I pulled those out for my project. I had these Recollections little stockings that I used. And I had paper from Tim Holtz. Now the Tim Holtz paper that I have, I'm not sure, I think it's probably an older stack because it's one that I picked up at a Tuesday morning. And so I don't know if it's currently available or if it's an older stack, but it was a holiday edition of a paper stash. So that was my base paper. I also used a couple of sheets of paper from Recollections from 8.5 by 11 sheet pack that I picked up from them last year. And I will show you that in just a minute. And now we get to the Three Girl Jam goodness. You will see in my project both of these gorgeous ribbons. The first one is the green and white, and the next one is the red and white. And these are from the Ribbon Candy edition, or a Ribbon Candy pack at Three Girl Jam. Aren't they gorgeous? I was afraid I was going to use a lot of the red, and I did use a lot of it, but I still have plenty left to do more fun projects, so I can't wait to show you more fun projects using these. I also use some of the new flair. Now this is a piece of the new Christmas flair that's available. She also has some thank you flair available, but I just started with the Christmas flair packet, and this is a piece of reminds me of peppermint candy, but I used another piece from that flair, and I'll show that in a minute. And then we have a new product over at Three Girl Jam that's been there for the last couple months, and it is this jute type string and then also ribbon. And it comes in a variety of colors, and they all come together. The colors come together. It has a hunter green and kind of a gold color and a creamy color, a really pretty mulberry reddish color. And one that looks kind of like burlap. It's such a fun packet, and it has such a nice feel. So I used all of those on my project, and the project that I made is actually for my nephew and his wife, and it's for their Christmas gift, but I gave it to them, I'm giving it to them early so that they can use it this year. And this is the book that I made. Now, if you have seen my videos, if you're new to my videos, then this is probably new to you. If you've seen my videos, you know that I like to make books or altar books. And this is just a standard composition book that you just pick up in the office supply section. I usually pick mine up at Walmart or somewhere. And I usually try to pick them up or at when back to school sales start going, because sometimes you can get them 3, 4, 5 for a dollar, or even up to a dollar a piece is, I think, is a good price for these. And I just love the way it turned out. So this is that Tim Holtz stash. And if you were watching my video the other day, this was that beautiful flower that I made using the red ribbon. And this is the piece of flair, which the glare is catching there. But this is the piece of flair that has, it's like a Subway title. And I really like this. I really like that the particular ones that I have are flat back because they glue so well onto my flowers. They do also come in pin back if that's what you prefer. And then I use the piece of that jute here. And then the green I use all the way around the edge just to provide some interest. So that's the cover. Now I want to show you the side because I did something a little bit tricky here. This is just some of that floral trimmed, kind of shabby chic trim, and I just picked mine up at Joann's the other day. But if I put it directly on the binding, then the red showed through. I mean, I'm sorry, the black from the regular tape binding from the composition book, and I didn't want that. So what I did is I took another tried and true Christmas ribbon, and this is the holly ribbon from the Christmas bundle, and I took some of that and I taped it down first, and then I put the rose trim over the top, and it was perfect. It looks perfect. You have just that piece of green coming through, which is the perfect match for the green in the paper. This is kind of a contrasting color, but the green of the holly berry was a perfect match. So it looks like it just all goes together, which is what I love. Now, I've divided these books. These books I have created for my family. I made several of them last year, and I have several more to make this year. And they're books for holiday traditions. Now, if you come back, keep an eye out. Be sure and subscribe to my channel or my blog, because sometime soon I will be updating you on the one that I made last year for me, which has a few more categories. And I will show you, now that I've been using it for a year, I will show you how I use it and some things that I do with it. And I hope that you will find it helpful. But for this one, I divided it just into five sections. I have traditions, memories, recipes, photos, and gifts. And so I divided that into those sections. And then just to add some interest, I just put the little stockings on the front of each of those pages. I taped the pages on both the front and the back to provide a good strong binding for the pages. And then when we get to the back, to the recipes, I've added with some washi tape, and actually I taped them down and then I added washi tape over the top, but I added some extra recipes that are family recipes for them, and then the rest they can just kind of fill out as they go. So there I have my project for the Three Girl Jam blog hop, and I hope that you enjoyed it and that you are inspired to go out and maybe start your own family tradition book. So thanks so much for stopping by today, and remember, take some time to enjoy the little things. Have a great day. Bye.